Hey, this is Nate Storey with Bright Agritech. Today we're going to talk a little bit about magnesium as part of our ongoing series on managing your nutrients in your aquaponics system. We've talked about the three primary plant nutrients, and this week we're concentrating on secondary macronutrients. Magnesium is one of these, and it's really important to the plant, almost as important as a few of the primary plant nutrients. So magnesium exists in your system with a positive charge, and you've got magnesium just kind of floating around your system. And I will say magnesium is one of the big three. It interacts really strangely with calcium and with potassium as well. So that's another reason why you should download the deficiency key and learn how to diagnose magnesium, especially when you learn how to diagnose calcium and you learn to diagnose potassium. Magnesium is mobile in the plant, which basically means that as the plant needs magnesium in the growing parts of the plant, it can kind of scavenge it from older parts of the plant. So oftentimes when we start to see magnesium deficiency, it shows up in the older leaves. Now, what it typically looks like is interveinal chlorosis, just generally. It's a yellowing of the tissues. They turn yellow or they turn white between the veins. And it's important to understand what the kind of the specific parts of magnesium deficiency look like, because they can resemble potassium deficiency in some instances, and in some instances, even calcium deficiency. So one of the reasons that you see chlorosis as part of the magnesium deficiency is because magnesium is really, really core. It's integral to photosynthesis. So as the plant begins to lack magnesium, what ends up happening is the chloroplasts end up breaking down, and the ability of the plant to photosynthesize is really decreased dramatically. So look for that chlorosis and look for some of the more specific symptoms and use the key to do that, because it can be pretty tricky figuring out what a magnesium deficiency looks like. I will tell you that potassium is the most common deficiency in aquaponic systems, and then calcium and magnesium are kind of second to that and are oftentimes interrelated. So be thinking about that pretty carefully. Now, if you do think you have a magnesium deficiency, there's a few different ways that you can treat it. So if your system has a neutral pH or runs a little bit high, you basically want to use something that's neutral to treat your magnesium deficiency. And most commonly, this is Epsom salt. Cheap, regular, old Epsom salt. You can get it at the drugstore, at the dollar store, Walmart. It's really inexpensive and it's really, really effective as a magnesium supplement. Okay, so Epsom salt is a magnesium sulfate. It's basically magnesium with some sulfate on it, SO4, okay? And you can add that to your system, and there are varying rates. I'm not gonna give you a dosage right now because it really depends on what your starting magnesium, the starting concentration of magnesium is in your system. But you can add Epsom salt, you can add actually quite a bit of it. It's not gonna harm your system, typically. It's pretty darn benign stuff. Now, you don't wanna go and just dump a whole box of Epsom salt into your system, but you can certainly go and add a few ounces for larger systems and continue to treat until you actually see that magnesium deficiency start to go away. So then, that's the best way to take care of it in systems where your pH is rather high. If your system pH is low, then what you want to use is hydrated lime or agricultural lime. Okay, agricultural lime is a hydroxide. It's a mixture between calcium and magnesium hydroxides. And depending on the lime that you'll get, you'll see it tested at different rates. Some of it has more magnesium than other types of hydrated lime. So check the bag, check the rating on it. But in low pH systems, a mixture of hydrated lime and potassium hydroxide are what you want to use to raise your pH or to condition your pH. So as you're doing that, as you're adding potassium hydroxide and hydrated lime, you're not just raising your pH, but you're also supplementing magnesium, calcium, and potassium, and helping to keep those elements all balanced in your system. So that's it, short and sweet as far as magnesium is concerned. Again, make sure you get the deficiency key and you use it to diagnose so that you're being sure that what you're seeing is potassium or magnesium or calcium. Remember, they can look very similar depending on the crop and depending on how they're kind of manifesting. So make sure you download that key. If you like the video, please subscribe and check out the Vertical Food blog. We're going to be putting up a post with more details on managing magnesium and what to look for when it comes to magnesium deficiencies. Thanks for watching. So historically, we have had to supplement systems with potassium, whether it's a potassium carbonate or a potassium-based hydroxide. We're adding potassium to the system.